This Torah class is brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.
Good morning, Rabbi Isai. So today, I want to do just an idea that came to me this morning about, those holachos that just guys just don't get through sometimes.
I mean, maybe it's just too many. It's becoming too many. The list is becoming, bigger and bigger of those halachas that people don't get to. But this is one of them. You know, it's an interesting halacha. It's a halacha that most people don't even read. Oh, we have to learn that halacha. It's a great halacha. It's an interesting halacha. You know, there's a chiyuv of Kriyas HaTorah on Shabbos, on Monday, and on Thursday. Now, where did it come from? We all know the Gemara and Baba Kama. Everybody knows. Ezra HaSofer was Pesachin. We want the Torah never to be forgotten. We wanted everyone to, even those people that are in the villages, maybe working, they haven't got time to learn so much. We want the Torah always to be something that is constantly being learned, at least every few days. That's why Ezra was Masakan Monday and Thursday. Mishra Rabbeinu, it's Shai in the Gemara, exactly which way around it goes. We're not going into that in the moment of time. But I do want to mention that, sometimes Kriyas HaTorah people sort of take very lightly. I've seen, not here obviously, but in various places in my travels all over the world, you see people come to Kriyas HaTorah, straight out the door. No, that's okay. Davening is davening. Now we can go out and schmooze with a 20-minute break, or if it's a double parasha, 25 minutes, and we can go out, schmooze, we'll be back. Obviously after the Haftorah, not Chas v'Shalom, before the Haftorah, we'll be back. And that it's good enough, right? Do I have to listen to the, Kriyas HaTorah? It's actually, by the way, it's a shayla which we're not going into now, because it's too complicated to go into the ramifications. But, right now we have a major problem that in Chutz La'aretz, they're doing, different parishes than they are in Eretz Yisrael. So anyone that either was there for Pesach in Chutz La'aretz and came to Eretz Yisrael after, or not even that, you have people that go to Eretz Yisrael for a Shabbos or go to Chutz La'aretz for Shabbos sometime between Pesach and Matzis Maaseh, whatever, all the way down over there by the 3 weeks. You're stuck because they're doing different parishes. Now, does that mean I have to listen to the one that I missed? Or do I say, which again I'm not going into now, because I want to just discuss something else today. The other tzad, by the way, not to, is that it's a chayvus tzibur. It's a chayvus tzibur to do it. Now, I'm not a tzibur, I'm a yochin, and therefore I missed it. I'm not going to make the entire tzibur go along and lay in something else. What's that? That's not true. The entire tzibur did not miss it. Because many people, as what many people have told me the last few days, that they actually heard it by Mincha, the Shabbos before they left. They especially did it because they knew that everyone's going back to Eretz Yisrael and never did it. I guess some people missed that Mincha. No, they didn't do it everywhere. But we will not announce your name. It's okay, don't worry. Some people missed that. Whatever it is, the point is, it's a good Shaila.
Do we or do we not have to take the entire Tzibur and do the Parasha that they did last week in Chutz La'aretz that we missed and therefore have to go and do that again? Now, like I said, the halachic ramifications of the shayla are quite huge, and I'll just tell you, just for the sake of simplicity, la halacha la maisa, we do not have to this Shabbos lay in, for example, parashas kedoshim. We don't have to. We're going to do parashas ebo. Now we could, maybe we will, but we don't have to, because parashas is a chayvas tzibur, which means that when the tzibur have a chiyuv, then we have to go with that chiyuv. Here you cannot say the tzibur. There are people that are daven here, for example, that were in Eretz Yisrael over Pesach, and therefore they did not have this problem. There are people that heard it over Mincha, and therefore they don't have this problem. The entire tzibur doesn't have this problem, right? That's why we're not going to parashas do it. But again, maybe we will. It's a hider. It's not chiyuv. Now, I just want to talk about the inyan of Kriyas HaTorah, because again, I do find that people sometimes just take it too lightly. Kriyas HaTorah is like, pass the time, get a book, read, do something during Kriyas HaTorah. I want to tell you what the Zohar Kodesh says. Coming up to Lag BaOmer, everybody has to go up to Meiron, to Reb Shimon, Heilige Reb Shimon, Kedai Reb Shimon, Lismay Chalav, everybody's busy with Reb Shimon. After Reb Shaila, Reb Shimon. Reb Shimon, the Heilige Reb Shimon. Let's remember what Reb Shimon said. Right, there's many mimes of Reb Shimon. The Zohar Kodesh brings down, it's a Zohar Parashas Vayakel, just in case you want to look it up. The Zohar says that the time, listen to this, because it's important to remember, we just had it this morning on Thursday, but we're going to have it again on Shabbos, right? The time where we are reading the Torah from the Bima, when there's a Tzibur, there's a Minyan, and we're doing Kriyas HaTorah, says the Zohar Kodesh Reb Shimon Bar Yochai, as if we're standing in Har Sinai. And by the way, this is a very important nekuda. This is another reason why I'm doing this now, is because on Shavuos, if you look in the Ben Ishchai, for example, it's my big mairich on this. If you look that on Shavuos, we know that we the Kriyas HaTorah of Shavuos, after staying up the whole night, Shachris, and now comes Kriyas HaTorah, it's brought down in the Sforim HaKadoshim again, if you look at the Ben Ishchai for more Arichas, that a person is meant to mamish assume, think, mamish take on, that he's standing in Har Sinai being mekabel the luchos from the Rabbeinu Shel Olam. Now, unfortunately, many people, after staying up the whole night, they're very tired and they're falling asleep, and it's a shame. Which is a shame. Maybe a person should go to sleep at Alois or Nates in order to have some more koichas to be able to do that. Because, as the Ben Ishchai writes, the entire climax, the whole thing of Kabbalah Satorah of Shavuos, is to stand by the beam and the mokum of the Torah and to mekabel the Torah. That means when you hear the Aseres Hadibros, you're meant to say, "Wow, this is amazing! I'm being mekabel the Torah." Says the Zohar Kodesh, every single time there's a Kriyas Satorah, it's as if we're being mekabel the Torah and we're standing at Har Sinai. Now, you have to stand during Kriyas HaTorah. So the Maaseh Maharam brings down that you don't have, that he himself would stand. But Me'ikah didn't, you don't have to stand. But again, it's roif to stand during Kriyas HaTorah, because again, because of the Zoya, you have mekabel the Torah. And we all know that during, for example, whenever they do the Aseres HaDibros, Yisroel, whatever, we all stand up. Aseres HaDibros, we stand up. So says the Maharam, since Kriyas HaTorah is like standing by Har Sinai, so why would they don't do Kriyas HaTorah on the Monday and Thursday and they're doing Parashas Emor? Do you not have to do the same thing? So he writes, that Meikah, then you don't have to, but it's definitely worry for a person to do that. Now, the Maaseh, you should know, it's a Machlokes HaPoskim, this Alpi the Chassidish Shesvarim, the Arizal Be'ikah, the Arizal writes, you should dafka sit. That's why if you ever saw Rebbes or Tzadikim, or you ever saw, you know, even Chassidish Olam, they dafka sit during Kriyas HaTorah, because the reason why they sit, is because it's more of a kvias. That's one of the reasons that Rizal says dafka to sit. Now the Mishabura does bring down that it's a roi for a person to stand during the brachas. Again, it's a shaila whether you do or you don't. But again, the idea is that Kriyas HaTorah is a time that we're being mekabel the Torah. It's not just that Ezra Sofer was mesakan to read the Torah and therefore we're doing it. So Yaitzazan, we'll go in, we'll go out, we'll listen, we won't listen. It's a real thing. It's a real, real thing that a person has to realize. In fact, you know, it's brought down, for example, the Yavit springs down. That's the reason. You ever wondered why the Bima is in front? And in fact, by the way, you should know the Mishabura Paskins, the Alokha Lamais, and Hilos Tefillah. If you go into a shul, right, just imagine you're not in your regular shul, you're going traveling somewhere, and you walk into a shul, which they tell you is a shul, and you find the Bima right in front of the Oron HaKodesh. Not a Sephardi shul, Ashkenazi shul. You're not allowed to daven there, by the way. It's also for you to daven in that shul. Mishabura Paskins, Alokha Lamais. Because that's one of the things that the Apikosim, the Minim, instituted. When they changed the various customs, because you've got to go with the times, is they took the bima, what's it doing in the middle? And they put it in the front, because Kriyas HaTorah, we're going to open up the Sefer Torah in the front, there'll be some Edrash, that's where it should be. And they had all reasons, because that's how they do it in the other places of worship that other religions do, and that's how they change it. So we're passing the Lachal HaMais, if you find a shul, the bima's got in the front, you're not allowed to daven there. The bim has to be in the middle. Why does the bim have to be in the middle? What's the pshat that we put the bim in the middle? You ever wondered this? Dafka in the middle. It doesn't have to be exactly, you don't have to measure it in exactly the middle. The middle meaning that you've got inside of the poskim say. There should be at least, you guys didn't realize that how we set up this base medrash wasn't just like, you know, kafi stam. It was al pi halacha. We specifically put, I wonder if anyone noticed this, some of you guys did, that we specifically put two benches in front of the bima. Because as they state in the Svarim HaKadoshim, they should have a minimum of two benches from the bima to the Aron HaKodesh. So that's obviously how we set up the yeshiva, you know, in the way that halacha is meant to be done. If you have, and if somebody don't have space for that, that there should be space that people should walk around it. That's what the Mishabura Paskins. The bima is meant to be in the middle. Why, says the Yaivitz, again, coming from the Zoya Kodesh, that Kriyas HaTorah is Kabbalah, it's like Kabbalah's HaTorah, HaSinai. HaSinai is in the middle and Klal Yisrael are around. And therefore, you can't put it in the front. You've got to put it in the middle. You have to have space for people to do it. Doesn't mean that people have to be literally around, or that the kids always assume that you have to have a circle going around. Everyone has to be opposite. You have to be, you know, looking over, whatever. But lemaisa, it has to be in the middle. That's a very, very important thing. The Ramchal, at the end of Derech Hashem, not the end, whatever, in Derech Hashem, Perek Dalet actually, he brings down why Chazal Mesakin Kriyas HaTorah. What's the purpose of Kriyas HaTorah? So the Ramchal brings down that in the Rambam brings down that what happens during Kriyas HaTorah is that a person, again, this is a Rambam, very interesting, not a Chassidus Shazach, the Rambam said that a person can attain heights that are impossible during private learning. Now, I don't know exactly what Derech Hashem means by that, and what the Rambam meant by that, but it obviously means, like the Zohar Kodesh said, and we started with, that Kriyas HaTorah is a very serious thing. Kriyas HaTorah, when we're actually being Kriyas HaTorah, we're bringing out the Sefer Torah and we're opening it, we're reading it, we're getting an aliyah. By the way, that's another reason that people ask.
I know somebody that asked once, Rabbi Yonos and David, Rosh Hashanah Pachad Yitzchak, what's the meaning of getting an aliyah? Like, people buy aliyahs. Okay, so it's brought down a sense of tshuva, the person should get an aliyah during a sense of tshuva. But what's the point of getting an aliyah? Is it good to get an aliyah? Is it bad to get an aliyah? Does it make no difference to get an aliyah? Who cares? So Agav Yishun, the Mishmur says, you're supposed to give aliyah to Choshev B'nei Torah, Choshev Tamid HaChomim, people of Elach HaYidin. But the point of getting aliyah that Rabbi Yonos and David, Rosh Hashanah Pachad Yitzchak once said, is that you want to have a shaychus to Torah. Everybody wants to have a shaychus to Torah. When you have an aliyah,
you come into the Torah, opening the Torah, making a bracha on the Torah, you have a shaychus to Torah. That's what it is. The Gemara tells us, Baba Kama, Samach Beis, that the Nevi'im were masakin Kriyas HaTorah. Again, we mentioned this, Baba Kama, Monday and Thursday. So 3 days don't go without Torah. We cannot have 3 days without Torah. Therefore, if we only do Kriyas HaTorah on Shabbos, what's going to be during the week? Yeah, people who are working, they've got no time to learn, or they have got time, but they don't realize it, whatever it may be, and we have 3 days without Torah. Therefore, again, as we mentioned at the beginning, Ezra Sofer, Moshe Rabbeinu, whatever, Shani Gemara, Baruch and Baba Kama, we were masakin a Kriyas HaTorah every 3 days. Now, why Dafka says Tosfos Monday and Thursday? What's Epis Monday and Thursday? Why not Tuesday and Thursday? Right? So Tosfos answers, because you know that the Medrash, right? We're all familiar with the Medrash, that the Medrash tells us that on Thursday Moshe went up to Mekabel the Torah, and he came down on Monday. And since there's an Eis Rotzen on a Monday and a Thursday, says the Gemara, says Tosfos, that's the reason that they were Kovei at that time. There's a Rash, but there's a similar idea as well. Again, Rabbi, I'm not giving you a Chassidish as one. Tosfos. There's a special Eis Rotzen. That when they have Kriyas HaTorah, that a person has to realize. And again, this is, I'm not going to assume all the halachas. There's a lot of halachas of Kriyas HaTorah, making it, you know, getting an aliyah, not getting an aliyah. How do you do it? How do you not do it? You know, should you walk to the Sefer Torah, which the Mishnah Berurah brings down, that you're meant to love the Sefer Torah if it goes past you? You're meant to walk towards it. You're meant to grab it all with two hands and give it a kiss. You know, there are many halachas. The Sefer Torah is an unbelievable thing. The Gemara Marcus talks all about the cover that we give a Sefer Torah. But Kriyas HaTorah, I just wanted to talk about this just for a few minutes to give you an idea and maybe more of perhaps of an appreciation of what Kriyas HaTorah is. It's not just something we have to do, pass the time, finished. It's an Eis Rotzen. The Rambam, Tosfos, the Rashba, the Gemara are all telling us that Kriyas HaTorah is an opportunity that a person can get keshed to Torah. It's an unbelievable opportunity. And I just wanted to talk about that in order that we get more of an appreciation for Torah. And Be'ez Hashem, when we hear the Kriyas HaTorah on Shabbos, hopefully we'll have more of an appreciation for that. On Sunday, Be'ez Hashem, brand new halacha, back to Hilchos Shabbos. Be'ez Hashem, have a wonderful day.
You've just experienced another Torah class brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.